This is Kangaroo Island in South Australia. In this video, we'll use science to answer questions like, how did these rocks form? Where does honey come from? Can you toboggan on sand? And what happens to plants during a fire? Are you ready? Then let's get scienced! We started in our hometown of Adelaide and travelled across the sea to a small island called Kangaroo Island. As its name suggests, it's home to a heap of kangaroos, not just on the signs and money, but also in real life. One of the main attractions on the island are the remarkable rocks, which are located in Flinders Chase National Park. So how did these rocks form? A long time ago, really deep underground, solid rock melted and turned into magma. This magma started to rise up towards the surface of the earth. But still really deep underground, the magma started to cool really slowly, forming a type of rock called granite, which looks like this. Over time, the soil and the rock above the granite eroded and disappeared, leaving this big dome and large blocks of granite on the surface. Wind, rain, sea spray, and footsteps of visitors continue to slowly erode bits of granite, giving them these really cool shapes. If you look really closely, you'll notice that a lot of the rocks are covered in a golden orange and flaky substance. This is actually a living organism known as lichen. Lichen is an algae and fungi living together in the same space. They help each other to survive in some really weird places, like these rocks. Our next stop was Island Beehive, one of the places on Kangaroo Island that collects the honey made by bees. But how do bees make honey? Honey begins as a sugary liquid called nectar, which is made by plants. Bees drink the nectar from a heap of plants and then fly back to their hive. By the time they get there, the nectar has already started to break down into smaller sugar molecules in their stomach. The bee regurgitates the nectar and passes it on to a hive bee, which packs it away into a honey cell. Using its wings, the hive bee fans air over the nectar, which evaporates some of the water and turns it into honey. The bees then cap the honey cells with beeswax, and it ends up looking like this. This is a piece of fresh honeycomb. You can see the hexagonal shapes of each cell. Whoa! Our next stop was the Sahara Desert. Well, a place that looks like it, called Little Sahara. Little Sahara is a group of naturally occurring sand dunes. Usually sand dunes have plants growing on them, which helps to hold the sand in place. But many years ago, either a storm or a bushfire destroyed those plants near Little Sahara. This left the sand exposed to the wind, which blew it inland into these really tall and steep dunes. Now you can hire a sandboard or toboggan and slide down these dunes. I wasn't very good at the sandboard. This was my best one. But the toboggan was a lot of fun. Yeah! Our last stop was the coastal town of Yvonne Bay. From here we hopped on a quad bike and set off through some grassland and native Australian bushland. We travelled through an area burnt during the 2019-2020 Australian bushfires and could see just how much damage was done. But when we stopped, it was possible to see a heap of new plants growing back through the ash. These Banksia trees have a really cool way of surviving fires. They produce seeds in capsules, which remain tightly shut. But when a fire comes through, the capsules heat up and pop open. After the fire passes, the seeds fall into the ground and a new Banksia tree begins to grow. We saw a heap of other cool things on the island. It was an awesome place to visit, and we'll definitely be back to search the island again for more science in nature.